Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture series on the subject fluid mechanics and machines. And this is lecture number 10.1, 10th chapter, first lecture. The topic is dimensional analysis. So in this lecture, we are going to discuss about need for the dimensional analysis or use of the dimensional analysis and methods of dimensional analysis. And in the earlier lecture, we discussed about the fluid dynamics, laminar flow, turbulent flow, bound layer theory and flow through the pipe. And all the equations will be used here for dimensional analysis. Equations what we developed in the previous topics will be used here for dimensional analysis. So, the learning outcome for this student at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to define dimensional analysis, define dimensional homogeneity, explain Rayleigh method and explain the Buckingham pi method. There are two methods used for dimensional analysis. Dimensional analysis is a mathematical technique which may be used to form the relationship among the variables involved in the analysis of engineering problem. So, there are many variables in the engineering problem and the variables are grouped together in the form of non-dimensional numbers. Then the technique of grouping the variables into non-dimensional number and forming a functional relationship among the non-dimensional number, it is what called as dimensional analysis. So, the various uses of dimensional analysis or the need for the dimensional analysis. To represent the experimental result in concise form. So, we obtained experimental results. The various variables are, we conduct the experiment by changing different parameters and we calculate different parameters. All the variables are grouped together and we can represent the variables, present the experimental result in a concise form. To test the dimensional homogeneity of any mechanical, any fluid mechanics equation. To test the dimensional homogeneity of any fluid mechanics equation. To derive the rational formula for the flow phenomena. To understand the relative importance of non-dimensional numbers in the fluid motion. To plan for the model test and present experimental results in a systematic manner, thus making it possible to analyze the complex fluid flow phenomena. These are all the uses of dimensional analysis or need for the dimensional analysis. Dimensions, the various physical quantities used in the fluid mechanics, can be expressed in terms of fundamental quantities or primary quantities. The primary quantities are mass, length and the time and temperature. So, in fluid mechanics application, we are not going to use the temperature. The three important primary quantities are mass, length and the time. So, MLT. So, M is for mass, L for the length and T for the time, capital T for the time and theta for the temperature. All the other quantities expressed in terms of primary quantities are called derived or secondary quantities. For example, velocity, discharge, area, momentum, etc. So, all the quantities are in terms of, they are represented in terms of the basic quantities MLT. The expression for derived quantities in terms of primary quantities are called as dimensions of the physical quantity. Then, so the fundamental quantities, mass, length and the time, symbol is M, L and T. Dimensions also M for mass, L for linear dimension or length and T for the time. The geometric quantities are area A, so L square. Meter square is the area, so the L square is the dimension. Volume V, meter cube is the dimension, so the L cube is the dimension. Moment of inertia, meter to the power 4 or millimeter to the power 4, the dimension is L to the power 4. And kinematic quantity, linear velocity, L T to the power minus 1, angular velocity, T to the power minus 1, rotational speed, T to the power minus 1, acceleration, L T to the power of minus 2. Discharge, L3, L to the power 3, T to the power minus 1 meter cube per second. acceleration due to gravity lt to the power minus 2, kinematic viscosity L square t to the power minus 1, steam function L square t to the power minus 1, circulation L square t to the power minus 1, vorticity t to the power minus 1, and dynamic quantities force MLT to the power minus 2. Force the unit is Newton. Density kilogram per meter cube. So ML to the power minus 3. Specific weight ML to the power minus 2 T to the power minus 2. Dynamic viscosity ML to the power minus 1 T to the power minus 1. Pressure Newtons per meter square. Unit is Newtons per meter square. So ML to the power minus 1 T to the power minus 2. Shear stress ML to the power minus 1 T to the power minus 2 Newtons per meter square. Work Joule Newton meter ML square T to the power minus 2. Energy Watts. So Joules. Energy is Joules. ML square T to the power minus 2. Torque Newton meter ML square T to the power minus 2. And power ML square T to the power minus 3. So these are all the dimensions. The last column value you have to remember, or you should know the unit of all the quantities, so that from the unit you can write in terms of MLT. And next we define the dimensional homogeneity. So Fourier principle of dimensional homogeneity states that an equation which expresses the physical phenomena of fluid flow must be algebraically correct and dimensionally homogeneous. So the equation, whatever the equation we write in the fluid mechanics, we derive in the fluid mechanics, they should be algebraically correct and dimensionally homogeneous. An equation is said to be dimensionally homogeneous if the dimensions of the terms in the left side are the same as the dimensions of the right side. So for example, area equal to pi by 4 d square. So diameter L square. So area equal to L square. Similarly, any complicated equation, you have to write the dimensions of the unit in the of the terms in the left side, dimension of the parameter on the right side. So these two should be equal. So then only the equation is considered as dimensionally homogeneous. An equation describes the physical situation will be true only if both sides have the same dimension. The equation will be true or correct, algebraically correct, only when the equation satisfies the dimensional homogeneity condition. But remember that all valid equations must be dimensionally homogeneous. But not all dimensional homogeneous equations are valid. Any valid equation should be dimensionally homogeneous. But the condition, the reverse, all dimensionally homogeneous equations are not valid. Need not be valid. Okay, that is the condition that you have to remember. Dimensional homogeneity, the dimensions of both left side and right side of any equation should be the same. That you have to remember. And any equation we derive in the fluid mechanics, it should be algebraically correct and dimensionally homogeneous. And the methods of dimensional analysis. The method of dimensional analysis are based on the Fourier principle of dimensional homogeneity. There are two methods used in engineering for dimensional analysis. One is Rayleigh's method. Another one is Buckingham Pi method. So here we explain the Rayleigh's method and Buckingham Pi method. In the next lecture, we will be taking some problems on the Rayleigh method and Buckingham Pi method, so that you can understand the methodology or principle of using the two methods. Rayleigh's method. Rayleigh method is used to determine the expression for variables which depends upon maximum 3 or 4 variables only. So in the equation, when you have maximum 3 or 4 variables, then we can use the Rayleigh method conveniently. In case the number of independent variables becomes more than 4, then it is very difficult to find the expression for the dependent variable. So normally when you have more variable, more than 4, then you automatically will go to the Buckingham Pi method. So if you use the Rayleigh method, it is very difficult. The drawback of Rayleigh method is that it does not provide any information regarding the number of dimensionless group to be obtained as a result of dimensional analysis. So that is the problem. So very simple application is when you have only 3 or 4 variables, you can comfortably use the Rayleigh method and derive the functional relationship. So in this method, the functional relationship of some variables is expressed in the form of an exponential equation which must be dimensionally homogeneous. If x is the variable which depends on x1, x2, x3 up to xn. So x1, x2, x3 are the independent variables and x is the dependent variable. Then the functional equation can be written as x is a function of x1, x2, x3 up to xn. Then in the above equation, x is the dependent variable and x1, x2, x3 are the independent variable. The equation may be written as x equal to c, a function of x1 to the power a, x2 to the power b, x3 to the power c, up to xn to the power n. So, where c is the constant and the a, b, c, n, they are the arbitrary power. The value of a, b, c up to n can be obtained by the comparing the powers of fundamental dimensions on both sides. So, the fundamental dimensions are m, l, t. So, we have to write the dimension of x in the left side and dimension of all the parameters on the right side. Then we can compare the powers of the basic dimensions and then we find the value of the c. Right? Everything is determined. So, then we can write the Then, thus the expression is obtained for the dependent variable. Then, we can substitute there for C, A, B, everything, all the constant in the equation and we can get the functional expression for the dependent variable. Next one is Buckingham Pi method. So, the Buckingham Pi theorem states that if there are n variables dependent and independent in a dimensionally homogeneous equation, and if these variables contain m fundamental dimensions and then the variables are arranged in n minus m dimensionless terms. So, if there are n variable, both dependent and independent variable in a dimensionally homogeneous equation and if the variables are contain m fundamental dimensions, then we may write n minus m dimensionless terms. The dimensionless terms are called as pi terms. Mathematically, if any variable x1 depends on independent variable x1, x2, x3 up to x4 up to xn, the functional equation may be written as x1 equal to a function of x1, x2, x3, x2, x3, x4 up to xn. The equation may also be written as a function of x1, x2, x3 up to xn equal to 0. Then, in the dimensionally homogeneous equation contains n variables, if there are m fundamental dimensions according to the Buckingham Pi theorem, the equation may be written in the terms of n minus m non-dimensional group. So, the function, the equation becomes function of pi 1, pi 2, pi 3, pi n minus m equal to 0. Each dimensionless pi terms form the combining m variable out of total n variable with the remaining n minus m variable. That is, each pi term contains m plus 1 variable. So, these m variables which appear repeatedly in each pi term is called as repeating variable. So, x2, x3, x4 are repeating variable if m equal to 3. Then each pi term. So, we have repeating variable and the non-repeating variable. So, the repeating variables are the basic variables. Normally, how to identify the repeating variable? So, the repeating variable, one variable, so we said there are three types of parameter in the fluid mechanics analysis. One is geometrical variable, fluid geometrical property, fluid property and flow property. So, if we select the variables, repeating variable, minimum one variable should be geometric property, one variable should be fluid property and one variable should be flow property. That is the general thumb rule for identifying the repeating variables. So, if there are the repeating variables will be repeating in all the pi terms. Then we have the non-repeating variable. So, pi 1 equal to x2 to the power a1, x3 to the power b1, x4 to the power c1 and x1. Then pi 2 equal to x2 to the power a2, x3 to the power b2 and x4 to the power c2 and xn. Similarly, it will go pi n minus m equal to x2 to the power a n minus m, x3 to the power a b n minus m and x4 to the power c n minus m into xn. So, these are all the pi terms. Then each pi term we have to calculate by using the dimensional homogeneity principle. Where A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2 are constant, which are to be determined using the dimensional homogeneity principle. The value of the constants are substituted in the equation and the value of pi 1, pi 2, pi 3 are obtained. Then the values of pi terms are substituted in the equation, find the general expression for the phenomena. So, pi 1 is a function of pi 1. So, pi 1 is a function of pi 2, pi 3, pi 4 and pi n minus m equal to 0. So, that is the final statement. So, we have to identify repeating variable, non-repeating variable, and we have to write the pi terms. Then we have to calculate the values of the constant using the dimensional homogeneity principle. Then we have to write the pi terms, and then we have to find the functional relationship among the pi terms. So we can understand the Buckingham pi theorem in a better way when you take a few problems on the when you solve few problems on the Buckingham pi theorem. So, in the next lecture, we will take few example problem to understand the Buckingham pi theorem and Rayleigh's method of dimensional analysis. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I have written in the mechanical engineering subject, and you may find one book, Fluid Mechanics and Machinery, which will be useful for this particular subject. You can refer to it for more information and problem in the Fluid Mechanics and Machinery. And I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures of all the subjects mentioned here, and I upload the solution for gate question paper in mechanical engineering subject. You can subscribe the YouTube channel, use the video lectures for your better learning and pass in the gate examination. Thank you for watching. You please post your comments, subscribe the channel, and you can write to my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification or doubt in the subject. So we'll meet again in another video. We'll continue this dimensional analysis in next lecture. Thank you.